shore leaves, salary, alcohol, girls, holidays on Sunday, no work on ship, it's a traveling profession, it's an adventurous profession. Is it what you really think about Merchant Navy? So if you are currently going through this thought and if you have clicked on this thumbnail, then you are probably in two minds about joining Merchant Navy. So this video is for you all. In this video, I will clear some of the myths and misconceptions about Merchant Navy and what all things you need to consider before joining Merchant Navy. So hello friends, welcome back to Marina Mishra's channel. Whenever I ask youngsters why do you want to join Merchant Navy, they always tell me, sir, it's because of the uniform, it's because of the lifestyle. We get a lot of respect in Merchant Navy. Okay, I agree, you get all these things, but whenever you come on board the ship, I have seen many youngsters, they come, they sail for one to two ships and then they leave this Merchant Navy, or it gets really difficult for them to adjust to the lifestyle on board the ship, the amount of work pressure on this ship, the amount of stress on board the ship, the amount of things that people expect out of them, it gets really difficult for them to cope up on board the ship. So here are some of the points which you should really consider before joining Merchant Navy as a field. It's the nomadic lifestyle on board the ship. It's like you are at home for 2 to 3 months, then you go on board the ship for 5 to 6 months, and whenever you are back, you know what happens, my watchman, he is not able to recognize me every time I'm back after the vacation. So friends, it was just an example. But when you come to your home, when you come to your friends, when you come to your relatives, it gets really difficult to catch up with their lifestyle, because for 5 to 6 months you have been away, you have been away from them, and in most of the companies the internet connection is less or it's really weak, or you have to buy the internet connection on board the ship and it's really expensive. Like, you have to buy internet of 100 MB for around $10 to $15. So suppose 100 MB, and 100 MB is really nothing. You open your WhatsApp or you open your Facebook, 100 MB is gone, and $10 to $15 of your hard earned money on board the ship, it's gone. So the first point is, you all might be thinking that the salary in Merchant Navy is really exorbitant and we might be earning a lot of money on board the ship. So actually this myth, it was true 10 years back when the inflation rate was less and the personals on board the ship, they were earning too much as compared to the persons on shore. But nowadays the amount of salary which you are getting on board the ship, it has reduced significantly, and the inflation rate as compared to the amount you're earning on board the ship, it has increased. Also during the off periods in some of the companies you are getting money, but that is just like peanuts, and in most of the companies you're not earning. So during the vacations you're not earning any money, and on board the ship the salary, it has reduced. The second point is regarding the shore leaves. So the according to IMO, the rules and regulations, they are continuously changing in the maritime industry, and from the time ISPS has came in Merchant Navy, the amount of shore leave, it has reduced significantly. Also in most of the countries you're not allowed to go on the shore leaves. Then there are vessels like VLCCs, some of the Aframax ships and bigger ships, they do not go into the port. They are in the SBM or SPM, that is called single point mooring or single buoy mooring, and which is far away from the port, so there's no shore leave. The third point is regarding the food. There has been a lot of youngsters who text me on Instagram, they message me on Facebook, they ask me regarding the food on board the ship. So food on board the ship, it depends upon the nationality of the crew on board. If the nationality of the crew on board it is mixed, then the food will be mostly non-veg, and it will be consisting of chicken, mutton, ducks, seafoods. So it might be a problem for the vegetarians on board. But if you are on an Indian ship, Indian flag vessels, then the food on board the ship, it will be Indian. But if you are expecting a taste which you can get from a restaurant, hotels or from home, then it will be really disappointing for you all. The fourth point which I want to emphasize is on, most of you all think that Merchant Navy is a permanent job, but no, it's not a permanent job, it's a contractual based jobs. So if you complete a contract with a company, there's no guarantee that the company will take you for the second sale, provided they will take you for the second sale only if your appraisals are good and you have performed exceptionally well on board the ship and there's a decline in the Merchant Navy. So There's no guarantee that they will take you in the next sail or they might not take you in the next sail. So your performance on board the ship and your relations and your attitude on board the ship, it's really important. The fifth point is the lack of medical care on board the ship. On board the ship, no one is authorized to perform a surgery or no one is authorized to give you medicines on board the ship. Okay, there are dedicated officers on board the ship who act as medical officers, but they are not doctors. So if you face any problems related to your health on board the ship and you are in the middle of the Pacific or Atlantic, then it becomes really impossible for anyone to act in such conditions. Also, if there's a problem in your home or if there's a problem with any of the family members, your friends, your relatives, or with anyone, then it becomes really difficult for you all to cope up in such conditions. The sixth point is about the sponsorship. There's a huge misconception among the youngsters that the sponsorship means the company will pay for your fees and for all the cost which is related to your training. No friends, sponsorship just means that you have to pay your own fees, you have to pay your own cost, and whenever you complete your courses, the company will directly give you job on board the ship. The seventh point is the less crew members on board the ship. Now, as the technology is advancing, the ships are also getting advanced and the ships are getting more and more electronic. So the number of personnels on board a ship, consider a ship of 250 meters to 300 meters. Now you can imagine such a huge ship, and on such a huge ship, there are only 18 to 20 personnels on board the ship. And there are about more than 150 machineries on board the ship, and these 150 machineries, they have to be handled by only 4 engineers on board the ship. And the navigational part, it is also getting more and more electronic, and only 4 officers are there on the bridge to handle all the pressure. So you can imagine the amount of pressure on board the ship. So friends, this was the video on the points you should consider before joining this dynamic maritime industry. If you have liked the video, do like the video, please subscribe to my channel, do comment on this video, and you can follow me on Instagram and have a conversation with me on Instagram. So all the best friends, see you all on ship.